virtue of my long experience in Borno State as secretary to said government. However, the federal government must do something concrete and practical about the wide and porous border with Chad, Niger, and Cameroon. Between Borno, Yobe, and Adamawa states, where the federal government has currently declared a state of emergency, there is more than 1,000 kilometers of unprotected and therefore porous border. There is free and unhindered movement of people and goods within those border areas. The immigration and customs lack basic border patrol equipment and grossly short of trained personnel. A whole control of immigration in charge of a state may not have a vehicle for even his official function, not to talk of patrolling the border. The ECOWAS policy of free movement has further compounded the already acute problem. I recall that in 1980, when I went for my postgraduate studies in the University of Manchester, UK, visa was given at the airport. There was no problem at all. But the United Kingdom changed its policy over time because of abuse. So if the ECOWAS free movement policy, for those of you who may not know, among the 16 member nations of ECOWAS, people just keep moving. You don't need any visa, you don't need even a passport. So as a result of that, this facility has been abused. People come in anyhow to Nigeria and go out anyhow, and with anything. So we advise that the federal government should review this policy of free movement. The federal government needs to resuscitate realistic bilateral cooperation between its neighboring countries, especially Cameroon Republic, with a view to facilitating effective checking of insurgents. Aerial border patrol using latest surveillance equipment is imperative. And let me give you my experience in Florida. In 1992, I was in Florida. The Floridian government uses an aircraft called the Sea Dog for its border patrol. I was then the National Director of Border Patrol of Nigeria. I came and I was introduced to the aircraft. We took off from the airport, and believe you me, we landed on the ocean. Yes. And it became a speedboat, that Sea Dog, for those of you who may know. Before I knew what was happening, we were also in land. It became a vehicle. It was going in the bush at the bank of the Atlantic. And we came back, it became a speedboat, it took off and landed in the airport. I recommended that aircraft for procurement to the federal government. But instead of buying that particular useful aircraft, so the government in its own wisdom decided to buy Dunia Tutu A. The general knows Dunia Tutu A very well. Dunia Tutu A has no purpose at all for border patrol. It is now, I bought about five. They are used for VIP shuttle. And one cost of one Dunia Tutu A would have procured three Sea Dog aircraft. That is the problem. The role of Borno State. Nigeria being a federal system, the executive governor of Borno State is the chief security officer. Although he is a civilian, he chairs the meeting of security chiefs serving in his state. In that advantageous position, the executive governor complements the effort of the federal government by providing accommodation to the joint task force, providing patrol vehicles and such other logistic support. However, the constitutional responsibility for the maintenance of law and order remains that of the federal government. The police are under the federal government, i.e. there is nothing like state police in Nigeria. The police has been given the responsibility to maintain internal security, but so far they have woefully failed. The army has the constitutional responsibility to protect our territorial integrity and to avoid external aggression. But they are now deployed to do the work of the police because of the failure of the latter. Borno State Government is therefore helpless. It has no control over federal agencies, neither does it have the resources more than paying salaries and undertaking basic projects for the good of its harassed, intimidated, and dejected individuals. In spite of the constraints posed by the challenges of insecurity and paucity of funds, Borno State Government has done the following within the short period of 2 years. There is no greater security like the contentment of the ordinary man on the street. Poverty, unemployment, and crime are three evil brothers that can bring down any society that takes them for granted. Poverty and unemployment mostly lead to crime. Engaging people is so important because, like the saying goes, an idle mind is the devil's workshop. Even if you have money to give as social welfare to citizens, it is always important you create what they will do every day so that you take them away from sitting down along the street or staying idle because of crime mostly feasts on the empty minds that are not occupied by routines. A United Kingdom leader once said that he will create jobs in the UK even if it means destroying the famous London Bridge and reconstructing it without adding anything to it, just for the purpose of engaging people. As a government, we have, from our first days in office, declared an unspoken emergency on job creation through integrated agriculture and vocational skills. We have built 2,500 houses with bricks and another 300 apartments in 50 upstairs that we call the Legacy Gardens along Bulungutu Road. We have done a lot in the area of education, in the area of health, and poverty alleviation. So in conclusion, I want to emphasize that both the federal and Borno State governments are doing their best to confront squarely the challenges of insecurity. There is therefore light at the end of the dark tunnel. Although politicians are people who, when they see light at the end of the tunnel, they go out and buy some more tunnel. To enable them to continue to grovel in the darkness. Otherwise, how do you explain the current political confusion and turmoil among the 36 governors who cannot conduct a free and fair election of their chairman? Or how do you explain the ruling party PDP and another one called New PDP? What about shouting bouts and boxing amongst members of the National Assembly? There are also segments of political groupings called APC governors, or PDP governors, or MHE faction, or Jonah Jam faction, etc. So, like people call America God's own country, we in Nigeria will have to invoke the name of God to save our country from its economic. And as for you members of the Nigerian in the diaspora, please try to come back home so that we can salvage our country together. Yes? Yes? Try to come back home. You cannot remain in New Jersey or Atlanta and expect to help your country meaningfully. You can do so, but meaningfully. Before you make up your mind, help your country with prayers. Finally, I once again thank the organizers of this conference and every person, group, and establishment that might have contributed in whatever way. As a government, I pledge our faithfulness to and express our willingness to cooperate with any person or group of persons and institutions with sincere motive helping in our reinvention. I congratulate Nigerians in diaspora organization for its abiding faith in Nigeria and for a successful conference. God bless the United States of America. God bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria.